Good morning and welcome. Our opening hymn is number 312, Table of Plenty.
Come to the feast of heaven and earth, come to the table of plenty. God will provide for all that we need here at the table of plenty. Oh, come and sit at my table, where saints and sinners are friends. I wait to welcome the lost and lonely, to share the cup of my love. Come to the feast of heaven and earth, come to the table of plenty. God will provide for all that we need here at the table of plenty.
Good morning, good people.
Good morning.
And welcome our viewers and listeners. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
These days, we can pray with our readings for this weekend, which are about miraculous abundance. And where there was a little, now there is much, both the first reading and the gospel. Speak of God's providing literally, looking forward. And there is a need, and behold, something is distributed for satisfaction. So we pray these days for trust in our times of need. We pray with faith for the grace to receive the Eucharist as a pledge of Jesus to accompany us, that is literally break with us. And we can pray with our letting what we consider small and insignificant to be placed in his hands and distributed to those in need. We can pray also with the histories we have of God's abundance in being faithful, provident, and nourishing in our lives. And so as we prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us acknowledge our sins, failures, and neglects, and ask the Lord for pardon and strength.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God in the highest, on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King, O God Almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away my take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord.
You alone are the Most High
Jesus Christ. With the Holy
Let us pray. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation, nothing is holy, bestow in abundance your mercy upon us, and grant that with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that ever endure, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the second book of Kings. A man from Baal Shalisha bringing to Elisha, the man of God, 20 barley loaves made from the first fruits and fresh grain in the ear. Elisha said, "Give it to the people to eat." But his servant objected, "How can I set this before 100 people?" Elijah insisted, "Give it to the people to eat. For thus says the Lord, they shall eat, and there shall be some left over." And when they had eaten, there was some left over, as the Lord had said. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The hand of the Lord feeds us. He answers all our needs. Your faithful ones bless you. Let them discourse of the glory of your kingdom and speak of your might.
The hand of the Lord feeds us. He answers all our needs.
The eyes of all look hopefully to and you give them their food in due season. You open your hand and satisfy the desire of every living thing.
The hand of the Lord feeds us. He answers all our needs.
The Lord is just in all his ways. The Lord is near to all who call upon him, to all who call upon him in truth.
The hand of the Lord feeds us. He answers all our needs.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, I, a prisoner for the Lord, urge you to live in a manner worthy of the call you have received, with all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another through love, striving to persevere in the unity of the Spirit through the bond of peace, one body and one spirit. And you are also called to the one hope of your call, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is over all and through all and in all. The word of the Lord.
Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus went across the Sea of Galilee. A large crowd followed him because they saw the sign he was performing on the sick. He went up on the mountain, and there he sat down with his disciples. The Jewish feast of Passover was near. When Jesus raised his eyes and saw that a large crowd was coming to him, he said to Philip, "Where can we buy enough food for them to eat?" He said this to test him, because he himself knew what he was going to do. Philip answered him, 200 days' wages worth of food would not be enough for each of them to have a little. One of his disciples, Andrew, the brother of Simon Peter, said to him, "There's a boy here who has 5 barley loaves and 2 fish. But what good are these for so many?" Jesus said, "Have the people recline." Now there was a great deal of grass in that place. So the man reclined, about 5,000 in number. Then Jesus took the loaves, gave thanks, and distributed them to those who were reclining, and also as much of the fish as they wanted. When they had had their fill, he said to his disciples, "Gather the fragments left over so that nothing will be wasted." So they collected them and filled 12 wicker baskets with fragments from the 5 barley loaves and had been more than they could eat. When the people saw the sign he had done, they said, "This is truly the prophet, the one who is to come into the world." Since Jesus knew that they were going to come and carry him off to make him king, he withdrew again to the mountain alone. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Friends, from time to time, we can find ourselves facing into situations that seem beyond our resources to manage. It might be the onset of a serious illness in our own lives, or perhaps or in the lives of someone we love, and we wonder how we will get through the challenging times that lie ahead. It might be the sudden death of a family member or a close friend. We wonder how we will ever be able to keep going without the person who has meant so much to us. It might be the case that our lives have taken a turning we very much regret. We have failed to do something we should have done, or we have done something we should not have done. We wonder We wonder how we will ever get beyond this lapse and make a fresh start in all kinds of ways. In all kinds of ways, we can find ourselves facing a future that seems uninviting. So in this morning's gospel reading, we find Jesus and his disciples facing a situation that seemed beyond their resources to cope with. They were faced with a hungry crowd and little or no means of feeding them. Now, in this situation, different people reacted in different ways. Philip made a calculation on the basis of the number of people and the amount of money available to buy food, and decided that nothing could be done. You could say that this was the reaction of the realist. The facts are the facts. And on the basis of the facts, these people cannot be helped. So we can all find ourselves reacting in that way to demanding situations. We conclude that the numbers do not add up, and we resign ourselves to doing nothing. Andrew was another reaction to the situation. He recognized that one of the crowd had a small amount of food, but he dismissed this small resource as of no value. This is the reaction of the person who belittles the resources that are there and the efforts that could be made to address the challenging situation. You could say it is the reaction of the cynic. And again, we can all be prone to that kind of reaction. There were two other reactions in the story that the gospel tells. There is the reaction of the small boy who willingly gave to Jesus the few pieces of food that he had. Now, this is the reaction of the generous person, of the one who is prepared to give all he or she has, even though it appears to be far less than what is needed. Such people are wonderful to have around when challenging times come our way. They do not allow the demanding situation to disempower us or them. They give all they have to give. Then there is the reaction of Jesus himself. He took the few resources that the young boy was generous enough to part with, and having prayed the prayer of thanksgiving to God over these small pieces of food, he somehow fed the enormous crowd. So as a result, everyone had more than enough to eat, and there was even some food left over. So St. Paul once made the discovery that God's power can be made perfect in weakness. God can work powerfully in and through very weak instruments like Paul himself. Now, in the gospel reading, Jesus works powerfully in and through what were, from a merely human point of view, very weak resources indeed. 5 barley loaves and 2 fish. Now Jesus took the resources that were given to him, and with them he fed the hunger of the crowd. The realist Philip and the cynic Andrew and all the other disciples discovered that the impossible became possible in the power and prayer of Jesus. So the Lord needs our resources of generosity and giftedness today as much as he needed the 5 barley loaves and the 2 fish of that young boy. If he is to continue to do his work in the world, if he is to continue to feed those who hunger for food, for love, for God. Now, in responding to all those hungers of his people today, the Lord will not bypass our own resources. They may seem very inadequate to us, but to the Lord they are vital. He asks us to give ourselves and our resources generously to him, to place ourselves, all that we have and all that we are, at his disposal. If we do that, we can never underestimate what the Lord can do in our own lives and in the lives of others through us. Today's second reading is from the letter of Paul to the Ephesians. Immediately before that reading, St. Paul declared that God's power at work within us is able to accomplish abundantly far more than all we can ask or imagine. So we can be surprised. We can be surprised at what the Lord's power can accomplish within us and through us, if we give of ourselves generously to him. Often our faith is not expectant enough. We can fail to appreciate how powerfully the risen Lord can work through generous lives. If we believe in a Lord whose power at work within us can do immeasurable more than all we ask or imagine, we will always remain people of hope, no matter how hopeless things may seem from a merely human perspective. So Paul reminds us in that second reading that we are all called into one and the same hope. And remember, as Christians, we are not disposed to writing off any situation or any person as hopeless. We never despair the enormity of the task that lies before us, whether the task relates to our own situation or the situation of those in greater need than ourselves. We continue to give generously of the little we have, even when the mountain ahead seems beyond reach. Because we know how powerfully the work can work through our generous efforts. And that's a good thing to remember. Amen. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made. For he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended to heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who at the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead. Brothers and sisters, in prayer, let us turn our hearts to our loving and merciful God and lift up the needs of those who hunger and thirst for salvation, justice, and the necessities of life.
That the Holy Spirit may help all members of the church to live in a manner worthy of their baptismal call, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
that the Lord may grant peace among nations, let us pray to the Lord. That our generous God may ensure that all who are hungry be fed, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord.
That the Lord may help those of us gathered here to bear wrongs patiently, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord.
That all who have died may be invited to the heavenly banquet, especially Jean Smith, Rita and Earl Sweeney, and Mabel and Arthur Mano. Let us pray to the Lord. And for our own intentions. We pray to the Lord.
And we pray for victims of violence and wars in Ukraine and Palestine, on their streets and in their homes, for the safety of all athletes competing in the Olympics in Paris. For all of them, let us pray to our Mother Mary. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now at the hour of our death. Amen. Hear our prayer, O God, and out of your unfailing abundance, satisfy the hungers of those who thirst in body and soul for the bread of life, that all peoples of the earth may be drawn by your bounty to the feast of the kingdom to come, through Christ our Lord.
Our offertory hymn is number 344, Gift of Finest to Eat.
You satisfy the hungry
that you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands will become for us the bread of life. By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity.
So when you call your family, Lord, we follow and
blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, for the divine and work of human hands it will become our spiritual drink. With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you. Lord our God, Lord, cleanse me from my sins.
We with joyful lips we sing to you our praise and gratitude that you should count us worthy, Lord, to share this heavenly food.
You satisfy the hungry
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal gladness through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery, and so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are filled with your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks broke it and gave it to his disciples saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. In song, let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, William, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom and the power and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your
spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. Peace of Christ be with you. Peace of Christ be with you. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
porque Dios es amor. We are the dwelling of God, fragile and wounded and weak. We are the body of Christ, called to be the compassion of God. And in vida, cuerpo del Señor, cup of blessing, blood of Christ the Lord, at this table, the last shall be free. You call me teacher and Lord, I who have washed your feet. So you must do as I do, so the greatest must become the least.
Please join me in reciting prayers to St. Michael. St. Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, Prince of the Heavenly Hosts, by the power of God, thrust into Satan and all the evil spirits who wander through the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. I have a few announcements. The tickets for the annual parish picnic on August 4th are on sale in the front of the church after all weekend masses. So adults are $12 and children under 12 are $9. All are welcome. We need volunteers to sign up to help at the parish picnic and different activities or tasks like bussing tables, serving food, assisting in the kitchen, and more are all needed. So you may sign up in the front of the church and someone will call you. Now, campaign update. We are aware that the diocese has not cashed several checks from the parish community. And we are working to clear that up so more accurate statements will be mailed to you. Now, total pledge amount to date is $553,452. Now, total amount collected to date is $205,217.93. Thank you very much for your generous hearts. Let us pray. We have consumed, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift which he himself gave us with love beyond all telling may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. And may the blessing of the Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. The Mass is ended. We may go in the peace of Christ. You have a blessed weekend.
Please join us in our recessional hymn number 200, Blessed by Your Sacrifice.